Welcome to this brief presentation of SDG Indicator 16.1.3. Violence, insecurity, weak institutions, and limited access to justice remain a great threat for sustainable development. In response, member states and the international community have committed to promote peaceful and inclusive societies, provide access to justice for all, and build effective, accountable, and inclusive institutions at all levels as part of the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. The United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime is the international lead organization on crime and criminal justice statistics. On such basis, UNODC has been identified alone or jointly with other UN agencies as custodian agency for 16 indicators to monitor relevant targets of the Sustainable Development Goals, mainly for Goal 5, 11, 15, and 16. This presentation focuses on the work of UNODC related to Indicator 16.1.3, and it will be particularly useful for agencies that are involved in the data collection, estimation, and reporting of this indicator. Indicator 16.1.3 is defined as the proportion of population subject to violence in the previous 12 months. To effectively measure progress towards reducing all forms of violence, the indicator is split into sub-indicators that will provide evidence on three different forms of violence: physical, psychological, and sexual. Measuring the experience of violence in a society is crucial for ending violence. Since such experiences are heavily underreported to the authorities, data coming from administrative police records are not suitable to provide reliable and comparable data on its prevalence in the population. Thus, Indicator 16.1.3 should be based on data collected through sample surveys of the adult population, commonly known as crime victimization surveys or CVSs. Using data from such surveys, the indicator will then be computed by counting the number of survey respondents who were victims of physical, psychological, or sexual violence in the past 12 months, divided by the total number of survey respondents. We would like to underline that three separate indicators should be computed and reported, one for each type of violence. One of the most challenging tasks in computing these sub-indicators is to have an internationally comparable definition of what physical, psychological, or sexual violence is. To prevent critical errors, the following definitions are based on the International Classification of Crime for Statistical Purposes, or ICCS, an internationally recognized tool for crime and criminal justice statistics. The tool was developed by UNODC and endorsed by the United Nations Statistical Commission and the Commission for Crime Prevention and Criminal Justice, the governing body of UNODC. The ICCS will be covered in more detail on the next slide. Physical violence is defined as the intentional or reckless application of physical force inflicted upon the body of a person. Examples include inflicting grievous bodily harm, assault with or without weapon, wounding, minor physical assault such as pushing, slapping, hitting, burning, and suffocating. Serious physical threats and robbery with the use of force are also considered as physical violence. Psychological violence is broadly defined as any act intended to induce fear or emotional distress. UNODC is currently working on improving the methodology on how to measure psychological violence through crime victimization surveys. Examples include acts of intimidation, serious threats of harm towards someone close, threatening expressions or words, illegal restraint or limiting contact with family or friends, including the use of social media, and damage of personal property, including pets. Finally, sexual violence is defined as unwanted sexual act or attempt to obtain a sexual act without valid consent or with consent as a result of intimidation, force, fraud, coercion, threat, deception, abuse of power or position, or use of drugs or alcohol or position of vulnerability. Examples include rape with or without force, as well as attempted rape. Other examples are statutory rape with a person incapable of consent by reason of law and physical sexual assault such as fondling or groping. As mentioned in the previous slide, the ICCS is a methodological tool that helps improve the quality of statistics for monitoring and evaluating public policies. It provides a comprehensive framework for producing statistics on crime and criminal justice by grouping crimes in a systematic way to build an effective statistical framework covering all crimes to facilitate their analysis. Implementing the ICCS improves the comparability between countries, data consistency among different sources of the crime and criminal justice system, and through time. This is why countries should rely on the ICCS to identify which criminal acts can be attributed to each type of violence under Indicator 16.1.3. On this slide, we see an extract of the ICCS on sexual violence that can help countries identify and decide which crimes should be included in SDG Indicator 16.1.3c, sexual violence. We can identify in the left column the hierarchical organization of the acts or events that constitute different crimes of a sexual nature, along with their description based on behaviors, rather than legal provision or terms. It is important to mention that the ICCS sometimes takes into account also context elements to define crimes, namely personal characteristics of the victims, personal characteristics of the perpetrators, and the context of the event. On the right column, we identify inclusions that guide countries with examples of crimes found in criminal codes around the globe that fall into this category. In the same column, we also find the corresponding exclusions. For example, prostitution offenses, trafficking in persons for sexual exploitation, exhibitionism, harassment, and stalking are all excluded from the definition of sexual violence and thus should not be included in the computation of 16.1.3c. Data for this SDG indicator are also collected from member states through the UNODC's annual data collection tool, the United Nations Crime Trends Survey, also known as the UNCTS. Currently, data are available only for physical and sexual violence. The coverage, however, is still limited as only 41 countries have produced data on physical violence at least once in the period between 2006 and 2018, and 32 countries on sexual violence. Looking at data for 2018 only, those numbers are significantly lower, as only 15 countries had produced data on physical violence and only 9 on sexual violence. To increase data coverage for Indicator 16.1.3, countries should invest in CVSs. They should be carried out on a regular basis to monitor progress towards reducing all forms of violence. Official partners in the country-level data collection process are national statistical offices, the police, the Ministry of Justice, Ministry of Interior, or the Prosecutor's Office. In addition to measuring Indicator 16.1.3, full-fledged CVSs can also produce data for other SDG indicators such as 16.1.4 related to perception of safety walking around the neighborhood, 16.3.1 that measures the population which reported its victimization to the relevant authorities, 16.5.1 that addresses experiences of bribery, and 11.7.2 related to victimization of physical or sexual harassment. CVSs are of immense value, as they are the only tool that can help understand and uncover the hidden figure of crime. In addition, they also enable analysis of violence according to other socioeconomic characteristics of the victims that will allow countries to design better targeted and more effective crime prevention policies. For those countries embarking on such a journey for the first time, UNODC, together with the United Nations Economic Commission for Europe, have developed a manual on victimization surveys that serves as a comprehensive source of information for developing national crime victimization surveys. Currently, UNODC, jointly with UNDP and the Office of the UN High Commissioner for Human Rights, are developing an SDG 16 survey module, which will be finalized in 2021 and will provide an important tool for member states. UNODC also provides technical assistance to countries wishing to implement a CVS following established international standards. There are several challenges related to the measurement of SDG 16.1.3. The most relevant is that not all experiences of violence are captured in general victimization surveys. As any other instrument, CVSs have their limitations, such as the victim not identifying him or herself as a victim, limited space in the questionnaire for covering a wide range of crimes, and sensitivity of some crimes that require a special methodology. Victimization surveys are restricted to adults of certain age. Children, for example, are usually excluded. A solution to this could be to have dedicated surveys on violence that are limited to selected population groups, such as women, children, or elderly. Such surveys, however, have the major limitation of not being able to portray the level of violence in the entire population. Another big challenge is the resource availability and political climate that affect countries' decision to conduct CVSs. Currently, many countries do not carry out these surveys at all, or they do so on a much less regular basis. That makes it difficult to monitor trends in certain parts of the world, and this is especially problematic in areas with high level of violence. On this slide, you can find additional references to the work of UNODC related to the 2030 agenda, as well as to other relevant resources for crime and criminal justice statistics. Please do not hesitate to contact UNODC for any other questions and inquiries relating to indicator 1613 or any other indicator that fall under our custody. You can also follow us on social media for regular updates on these topics. Thank you very much for your attention.